Hello everyone, my name is Itamar Ben David. I'm a tour guide here in Israel. I live in Jerusalem. And since COVID changed our life, we all moved to the virtual world. My colleagues and I have developed in the last year and a half a new language of giving tours online. So I want to share with you two types of virtual tours. One is called live on location and the other one is live from home. Live on location is actually more common. Most people, when they hear virtual tour, they think of a guide that is walking in the streets or whatever site he is in with a gimbal, this device, what you see over here, it's a gyroscope. So the guide is walking in the streets with his with this device, and his phone is attached just like that, is attached over here. And as long as he has signal and daylight, this looks terrific. So this is the type of virtual tourism that is quite common and became quite famous during COVID. I want to share with you a little video of a place where I give live virtual tours on location, the walls of the old city. So for example, you can see the Tower of David just over here. I can see West Jerusalem. And let's start walking a little bit just on the walls of the old city. So this is a great experience. The signal over there is terrific. People really enjoy walking on the walls of the old city and experiencing that and hearing the stories and whatever it is to be told about it. So although this is the more common type of virtual tour, I would dedicate more time now to the live from home just to explain how it works, okay? So live from home, we basically use Zoom as a platform for the most part, and we share a screen with pictures, videos, satellite pictures, three-dimensional models, pre-recorded interviews, and whatever else we want to share with our audience, with our virtual travelers, let's call it. So one way of doing it is Google Earth Project. So thanks to Google and Google Earth, we can actually travel all over the world and also in Israel and Jerusalem. So right now, this is a little project that I made for you. And I want to demonstrate a few different things through this one. Okay, so we landed from the sky down to the Tower of David. You can see the beautiful view from the Tower of David. You can see the Church of the Holy Sepulchre. You can see the Mount of Olives. You can see the Temple Mount, the Dome of the Rock over here, Jewish Quarter, Armenian Quarter, just beautiful. So thanks to these beautiful photospheres, we can actually visit the places. And with a guy that is live, you can actually interact with him, ask him questions. It's just beautiful. So let's jump now from the Tower of David, from that light, nice viewpoint, to the Western Wall. So another thing that I can add to Google Earth Project is pictures, videos, here, that's what you see on the side. So let's say I'm not satisfied enough with just this photosphere. Okay, this is how it looks like, but I wanna show how the Western Wall looks like in different occasions. So for example, I wanna show how it looks on Bar Mitzvah Day. Here, you can see the Bar Mitzvah families celebrating, okay? Another Bar Mitzvah boy is coming over here. And let's say I wanna show how it looks like during Sukkot, the Feast of Tabernacles. I can add a picture or two. I can show the notes and talk about the traditions of putting a note of prayer at the wall. That's how it looks like during Independence Day here in Israel. This is the priestly blessing during Passover, so you can see how packed it is. And I can also talk, let's say, about the diversity of Jewish origins. Jews are coming from 100 different countries of origin. So this is a nice example to show the Ethiopian Jews and maybe say a few words about them. The Western Wall is important because of its proximity to the Dome of the Rock. That's the Golden Dome that you see. And there's a bridge over here that takes us up to the Temple Mount. And that's what I want to share with you using this video. So as you can see, I'm still on Google Earth Project. I didn't move and still using just one tab. And right now we're on that bridge, that wooden bridge that we saw. Let's jump a little bit. Let's just jump a little bit over here. Let's walk here. You can see I'm on the bridge. I'm just taking a look at the plaza. And here is that bridge that we saw a second ago. So this is the only way for non-Muslims to enter. Muslims have other gates. This is for non-Muslims. And many people won't come to Israel, but even those who come to Israel don't necessarily go up there. I know many Jews that even live in Israel and won't go up to the Temple Mount because of all kinds of things related to purity rules. So this is a great way, a great medium to show them that these holy sites. Okay, so this is, we just entered to the Temple Mount. You can see Moroccan Gate, okay? Jump a little bit. I'll say something else about it. Many Muslims around the world can't come to Israel because of because there are no diplomatic relationship, let's say, between Israel and those countries. So the virtual medium is a great way for these Muslims to experience a holy site for them, such as Al-Aqsa, okay? Al-Aqsa Mosque, for example, okay? So that's what you see right over here. Moving forward a little bit, okay? Let's take a look at the Dome of the Rock. Here it is. See the Dome of the Rock. And let's turn around and see the entrance to Al-Aqsa Mosque. Here it is, okay? So this is a great way to experience the country. Let's move now to a different place from the Western Wall. Let's move now to the Via Dolorosa, okay? And the problem with the Via Dolorosa, as far as virtual tourism concerned, is that there is no signal over there. So live on location is not possible over there. So what is possible? For example, walking with a Google Earth, just like you see over here, here's the Via Dolorosa. You can see a group over here. We can see souvenir shop, okay? It's a great way to just walk around the city. And if you have a guy that you can ask questions, he's interactive, he's live, he's here with you, this is a great experience, okay? So this is one way of doing it. Another way is these walking tours that I showed you earlier. So let's jump now in the Via Dolorosa all the way to the Church of the Holy Sepulchre. This Russian nun. So of course, many people can't come to Israel right now. In 2019, we had four and a half million Christian travelers that came, 4.5 million tourists that came. Amongst them, many of them were Christian pilgrims that came to Israel. This is, of course, the height of their visit, the Church of the Holy Sepulchre, the place where Jesus was crucified and later buried and resurrected. So this is clearly an important place. Now, as far as, again, live on location virtual tourism concerned, this place has no signal. So it's impossible to walk around with the gimbal live, let's say Facebook Live, Instagram Live, and others, because people won't see anything. So what is possible, again, is to pre-record the walk and then just enter the church. So let's just go up to the Calvary. Just think about the guidance, think about the stories that the guide can tell, the pastor can tell, and here we are. We're looking now at the rock of the Golgotha. That's what you see here at the bottom of the screen. And we'll see the icon of Jesus just above the Golgotha. It's quite amazing. This is the height of the highlight of most pilgrims' tour. They would say a prayer over here. They can touch some of the stones and the places where Jesus' body was laid. So this is quite an amazing experience. Very cool. Okay, I wanna show you a few other things that we use while we give these virtual tours, specifically in Israel. There is a company called Simplex. They supply these three-dimensional models to architects. And this really helps us to show specifically here Jerusalem from many different angles. So I want to show you how it looks like, how it works. Beside of pictures and walking videos, we can also use this three-dimensional model as almost like a drone footage. You can see from many different angles, we can actually take different screenshots. So right now I'm above the Mount of Olives, looking at the Temple Mount, okay? And let's just take a look at this model. You can see the Temple Mount. Always takes it a few seconds to get to a nice resolution, but still nice. Still nice as it is. And let's go to the Church of the Holy Sepulchre. This is the plaza of the Church of the Holy Sepulchre, and you can actually see the ladder of the status quo from here, okay? From above. This is pretty nice that you can see all these details, okay? Good. I want to show you how a three-dimensional, how this three-dimensional model of Simplex could also work. We can actually create all kinds of videos. So this is a little example. This is Masada, also an important site in Israel. Let's take a look at this. You can actually fly above the Northern Palace and quite amazing. So you see that, that we can use all these features nicely. I want to take you back to the Dome of the Rock, which is a place that non-Muslims cannot enter. And thanks to a Muslim friend of mine, he took a nice video of it, so you can experience the Dome of the Rock from inside. Even those who come to Israel can't really visit this place. So this is the Rock of Jerusalem, the top of Mount Moriah, hence the Dome of the Rock. So that's the actual rock. And take a look at the dome above it. Quite amazing. Okay, so what is the virtual tourism good for? So first, it does give a great experience of travel, whether it's live on location or live from home, it does give a great experience of travel. It's great for people who have disabilities and not necessarily travel much, or people of old age that can experience all these people and feel like they travel around the world, which is great for them. Those who doesn't have the financial means or the time to travel, this is great for them as well. And it does solve, as we saw during COVID, it does solve even problems of loneliness, feeling loneliness, because we can create great communities of virtual travelers around a certain guide or a certain site or a certain a theme. So it does happen already. We have the experience of a year and a half. So that's why I emphasize that. It's also great for people who are in the business of tourism. It's great to keep in touch with your clientele. It's great for as a marketing instrument. You can actually, of course, sell those tours. You can keep in touch with your profession. Many of us guides who work virtually, we are in touch with our profession on a daily basis because we do guide, we do remember the places, we do guide in those places on a daily basis. It's also great for advocacy. It's great for educational purposes, specifically here about Israel. And it's great in general for schools, universities in the fields of geography, history, architecture, etc. They can really bring a new way of studying to this profession. So all in all, virtual tourism, that's the aesthetics of it. Live virtual tourism, that's the aesthetics of it. And that's what it's good for. I hope you enjoyed this video and keep in touch.